time to spar.
You got to kick their ass?
Dude, yeah, all the boxers were kicking. we were fucking them up, bitch.
Yeah! Hey!
So welcome to Beat the Count. And I should also mention something. You were the first fight ever on The Contender. Is that accurate?
That's right. When the first fights came out, I was the one, you know, that called out the toughest guy back in the day. And that changed my life forever.
And that was a then undefeated Peter Manfredo, is that right?
Undefeated, ranked number 3 in the world. He was lined up. Basically, they did this show, The Contender. I'm going to be brutally honest. I'm going to be brutally honest. The Contender was built around him. Stallone wanted an Italian version of himself. That's why he joined the show. And out of everybody they picked, they say, hey, this guy can beat all these guys, you know, eventually. But they didn't count on the little Mexican that could.
There you go, man.
So you know what the mistake was of the producer of The Contenders? Is that they were not into boxing. When they picked me, they said, oh, look at this, like chubby-looking Mexican, white, skinned, record of 10-2. But they had failed to realize that I was an alternate to the Mexican Olympics, where I actually won the whole thing. But they gave it to José Luis Sertuche, who had been in the committee for 8 years. They had invested 8 years in José Luis Sertuche. And here comes this Mexican from United States to Mexico and beats everybody. And they take the fight away from me, so he goes to the Olympics for me. They failed to realize that I had fought Ishe Smith in my third or second fight. And I beat him, and they gave him the fight on a split decision because of a low blow.
Yeah.
You know, my low blows, those hurt right here. Unless you have your balls, unless you have your balls right here on the liver, that was not a low blow. And, you know, they failed to realize that when I went into the Contender at 10-2, I had already faced, what, like 6 undefeated fighters, me coming in as the opponent, as the B-side,
yeah.
And I beat all of them. So, yeah.
But something else, though, is that you were also not naturally a middleweight at that time, right?
It's another thing. I was a welterweight coming up to middleweight. So, yeah, they obviously picked most of the fighters so they could be the B-sides. They were kind of looking to have Ishe Smith finished with Peter Manfredo. That's how they kind of had set it up.
Yeah.
Now, everything was real. I don't think everything was acted. Everything was real, but it's more about behind the scenes, which is exactly what happens in boxing. Boxers do not get paid to lose. People ask me, do you get paid to lose? Do they give you money to lose? That does not happen. That does not exist. There's not one boxer in the world who goes up in the ring and says, yes, I'm going to lose for money, at least from my experience. But when things are set up in a way for somebody to win and somebody to lose, it's behind the scenes.
Yeah.
As the people that are making the fights. And in this case, The Contender, it was the producers that had set it up for that. But, you know, shit happens, I guess.
So did they approach you to join The Contender, or is that something that you found?
No, I found. I was training in La Habra Boxing Club back in the day. And I saw a flyer that said Stallone was there, you know. And it says, yo, you a boxer? You want to earn $1 million? That's how I read it, you know, when I fucking saw him.
With his voice on, talking to you.
I swear. Oh, my God. Oh, shit. And I said, yes, I'm a boxer. Yes, I want $1 million. Come audition, blah, blah, blah. So I went to the auditions, and, man, there were so many people there. Where was that? I can't remember where the auditions were, but 100 people. Obviously, like, fucking... maybe 10, 20% were real boxers. The other 80% were backstage West actors with their resume coming in, you know, thinking it was part of the whole...
Like a show.
Like a show type of thing.
Yeah.
Well, obviously, you know, it was a reality show, so I'm sure they did like a press release to all the agencies, you know, acting agencies, and they had a whole bunch of actors there. Which, when it was time to spar,
you got to kick their ass,
dude. Yeah, all the boxers were kicking. we were fucking them up big time. All the actors, man, that was funny. That was a good experience.
Yeah, hey.